Despite the continued increase in COVID-19 cases, the palace says the Philippines is actually winning the war against the pandemic. Palace spokesman Harry Roque says proof of this is decreasing positivity and mortality rates for COVID-19, as well as the slowing of the doubling rate of confirmed cases in the country. Roque could not hide his joy as he pronounced that the Philippines beat the prediction of University of the Philippines experts that COVID-19 cases in the country would hit 40,000 by the end of June.
Wala pong katotohanan yung 10,000, 1,000 plus na lang pong ating backlog, which means we did not hit 40,000. Palalo na tayo. We beat the UP prediction po. We beat it. So congratulations, Philippines. Let's do it again in July.
Roque said President Duterte may announce a general relaxing of quarantine protocols in many areas around the country. But at least three local government units appealed to the IATF for stricter lockdown measures.
I remember that some of the appeals are from Cebu Province, the province of Bulacan, the province of Cagayan. Mas marami po gustong mas higpitan. Okay? Parang tatlo po yung mas gustong maghigpitan, isa po yung downgrading.
The World Health Organization meanwhile believes there's no need to implement stricter protocols in Metro Manila to control the spread of COVID-19. And localized lockdowns are enough to curb its spread.
We don't believe that the situation in the metro requires a reversal. We recognize the impact of this outbreak not only on health but also on the economy. And within the IATF recommendations, there is provision for localized lockdowns.
The situation, however, is different in Cebu City. Environment Secretary Roy Simatu, who was earlier designated to lead the government's pandemic response in the city, says there is a need for the continued implementation of the enhanced community quarantine in the city to avoid more infections.
Continue natin ng ECQ because ito din kaumpisa pa lang ito eh. Ay yung hindi kasi nung una na-announce yung increase to ECQ, hindi kaagad na naipatupad.
Simatu also noted the need for government to continue with hard lockdowns in 12 barangays in the city, which has registered the highest number of cases.
Ito ang tinututukan natin ngayon kasi dito ang majority of the cases in Cebu nang galing doon sa 12 na yan.
Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.